This video is for those of you working to create your rainbow dozens of eggs, because today we're going to talk about egg genetics and how to get certain egg colors. Specifically, we're going to discuss your dark browns, olives, blues, and greens. I also posted a really in-depth article, including some more reference articles and some really, really nice reference charts today about all of this over on my Patreon. So if you're not a member there, you should check it out. And also, given the government's current ploy for censorship, it may be a good idea to join my Patreon now, just in case anything happens to the TikTok, even though we all know it's for the people. And I digress. Before we get into the fun part and we start looking at some really beautiful eggs that I've collected from my flock, let's talk about some basic concepts for chicken egg color and their genetics. Each chicken has two genes which determine their egg color. They get one of these genes from each of their parents. Technically, eggs are only made up of two colors, blue and white. Those really beautiful browns that we see on eggs, those aren't actually the color of the eggshell. That is pigment that's laid on top of either a blue or a white egg after the egg has been formed in the oviduct. It's one of the last things that happens in the process before the egg is laid. Basically, any type of brown or cream or pink or heavy bloomed or speckled pigment on top of the egg is more like paint that's been coated over the color of the egg as opposed to the actual eggshell color. That's why when you have those really nice olives and you crack them open, the inside of the egg is blue and the outside is green. There's something like 13 other different genes that are responsible for the color of the shade that's coated on top of that blue egg that makes our greens, our olives, and our browns, creams, pinks, all those other different colors. When we have a chicken who has two genes that are for the same color, so we have a chicken that has two blue egg genes, we call that homozygous, when two of the genes are the same. When a chicken has one gene that they've gotten from one parent for blue and another from another parent for white, we call that heterozygous. They're different. Blue egg gene is a dominant trait, so if you have a chicken who has a blue egg gene from their true blue laying parent and a white egg gene from their Marans other parent, that blue genetic is going to express itself in the offspring because it's the dominant trait. The white egg gene is recessive, so even though it's present, we don't necessarily see it. So the reason that that's important is because sometimes even though you have a chicken who's laying blue or green, it doesn't necessarily mean that they will pass that blue egg genetic onto their offspring, because they may pass on that white egg trait. This is why when we're trying to create olives, we're starting out with a true blue layer, like an Americana or a leg bar. What we mean by true blue layers is those chickens carry homozygous blue egg genes. They carry two blue egg genes, so they are absolutely without a doubt going to pass off that blue egg genetic to their offspring. And then we use Marans. Marans carry two white egg genes, but they also pass off that characteristic to tint eggs really dark brown. The deeper blue eggs and the deeper brown eggs that we start with, the more saturated the egg color of the offspring is going to be. Now let me just show you some egg colors, because maybe all of this will make more sense. So when we cross a dark brown layer and a true blue layer, we get our first generation of olive egger. This offspring is heterozygous blue. This offspring has one blue egg gene from here, one white egg gene from here. So if we take this olive and we breed her back to a Marans rooster and she passes on that blue egg gene to the offspring, we get our first back-crossed olive. This hen here has the blue egg gene that her mom passed down and that beautiful brown overlay, the pigment from the rooster, and we get an even more beautiful, diverse olive from that pairing. This egg here is also an example of a back-crossed olive egger, so a first generation olive who was crossed back to a blackhopper Marans gave us these two color eggs. We get Easter eggers when we take really any color of pigmented egg, whether it's from an Orpington or a Brahma, and we cross them back to a true blue layer. In those breeding pairs, we see these lighter greens and blues and pinks. These are some various olive generations. This is our first generation olive that came from blackhopper Marans to Legbar, bred back to a blackhopper Marans rooster, gives us our BC1 olive. This is another BC1 olive. Here's another variation of olive using lighter browns to start with, gives us a lighter color green. I've said before that chicken genetics aren't an exact science, but there is a little bit of science to it. What I mean by saying there's not an exact science is there's no way to tell exactly what color we're going to get from our offspring, but there is some factors that come into play. I hope this video has been helpful and not just further confused you.